The following video contains spoilers. We suggest watching the episodes alone in the dark. Hello, Wolfpack! Tonight we check out a haunted pumpkin story from the demented Mindscrew studio known as Crypt TV! Again, Pumpkin Demons Round 2! So, our webisode opens up on a pumpkin!
What?! Pumpkin?! Pumpkin what?! 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 Pumpkin what?!
I know, shocking, right? But we then meet our main characters, a gang of generic idiot bullies.
Ah!
Not trying to start this little chit-chat of ours on a sour note this early, but I'll get the worst part of this short film out of the way right now. The idiot bullies are supposed to be teenagers, but they are all clearly a bunch of 40-year-olds. We're meant to believe these people are kids causing some Halloween mayhem, but they are old. The casting decision is the most glaring flaw of this whole adventure. I mean, for crying out loud, one of the teen bullies couldn't even be bothered to shave off his 5 o'clock shadow. Excellent commitment to the part, bro.
Like, dude, we're like totally 15. Let's get jiggy with the Lil Romeo records, home fry.
Their acting is perfectly fine, yet the age is a cosmetic flaw that could distract some. But that's mostly the negative here. The rest of this tale is pretty straightforward and real scary. The idiot bullies here spend their Halloween night smashing pumpkins! Yep, that's their gimmick, killing innocent pumpkins. Gosh, what a bunch of losers. What sick satisfaction do they get out of crushing children's Halloween artwork?
That's a good question! And the answer is...
to be a dick!
On a fun side note, this entire short film is in pure silence. Not one word of dialogue is ever uttered at all, relying on the actions to speak for themselves. That's quite unique, and honestly demonstrates how Crypt TV can pull off smooth storytelling through the acting alone. Much like the drawing, I think the horrors we see are gripping enough on their own, and grant a nice visual experience. It's a rather nice homage to the silent horror classics of yesteryear. Another job well done, Crypt TV. Though, points off for not having the idiot bullies here smashing pumpkins to the tune of the band Smashing Pumpkins. We'll fix that.
Oh God! Everywhere I look, pumpkin atrocities!
So yeah, you get the gist of the idiot gang's shtick. They love smashing pumpkins for a cheap thrill. All except for one, the lead idiot's girlfriend. Because she cares for the sweet innocent pumpkins and wants no hand in murdering these poor gentle faces. Hashtag pumpkin lives matter. When the idiot bullies demand that she smash one, the lead idiot's girlfriend dumps him and sulks off in disgust.
I don't get it, bro. What chick doesn't get horny over pumpkin death?
That's a good question! And the answer is...
I have standards.
So clearly, after losing the love of his life, the idiot bully will now rethink all his choices and change himself for the better. Nah, he just gets blind stinking drunk and goes on a rampage, killing even more pumpkins.
No!
So, the idiot bully gets totally wasted and wanders around town to angst until he spots a lone jack-o'-lantern taunting him, just sitting there down a sketchy dark alley, which, of course, he absolutely has to kill. Yeah, this obviously isn't a trap. Who the heck even leaves an ominous jack-o'-lantern down a dark, scary alley like this?
That's a good question! And the answer is...
a dark side.
But when Idiot Bully crushes the pumpkin for mocking him, he spots... the Life is Strange power symbol. Huh? Why do these random pumpkins have the time travel logo from Life is Strange on them? Does this mean that the Life is Strange saga and the Crypt TV world share the same universe?
That's a good question! And the answer is...
oh my god, who the hell cares?
Apparently, all the pumpkins Idiot Bully and pals smashed had this logo on them, hinting that some mysterious force had been watching them, outraged by his cruelty towards the defenseless plants. Where, haha, this was revealed to have been a trap all along, as the pumpkins surround the Idiot Bully. Yep, you're not on drugs. The pumpkins surround this jerk because they seek their...
revenge!
You see, this was all a brilliant plan to capture the lead moron, orchestrated by... Pumpkin God. Wait. There's a Pumpkin God in this world? A Pumpkin God? That's so awesome! I want to learn more about this mysterious figure. Why can't Crypt TV give us a movie focusing on this creature? A pumpkin god sounds so epic! Now this jack-o'-lantern beast is only on screen for a few seconds, but he definitely leaves a horrifying, memorable impression. Pumpkin God desires vengeance for his/her lost children, so now divine intervention has arrived at last. And the spirit of Hallow's Eve punishes Idiot Bully by turning him into a pumpkin.
Irony!
Yes, he's in their shoes now, but uh-oh, his idiot buddies show up, still trying to teach his girlfriend the joys of killing pumpkins. And you can all guess where this is going.
Guess he should have quit while he was ahead.
And thus, Pumpkin God shows us all why he, or she, is the true Messiah of Hallow's Eve. Anyways, that was the crushing conclusion to Crypt TV's short flick, Jack-o'-Lantern. Once again, we've managed to review another killer demon pumpkin story just in time for October. And honestly... I did kind of like it. Now, this is far from Crypt TV's best work, but as a standalone feature, it's decent. Much like The House of No Return, this is obviously a comeuppance story, but one that does cut out all the fluff to get right to the point. Pun intended. Basically, it teaches us a what goes around comes around lesson. The idiot bully broke all these family jack-o'-lanterns for a sick laugh, then he gets put in their place and won his bad Silent Hill ending as a punishment for his evil misdeeds. Simple plot, but super effective. Again, the only awful part in this tale is the blatant ages of our actors. I do not for one second buy that these guys are teenagers. Sorry, Crypt TV, I love you, but you could have easily written around this. Though, I will give credit, the adult cast still delivers very good performances overall. The worst element is just a distracting surface-level issue. Also, I want more of Pumpkin God. He/she was on screen for such little time, but it was so disturbing. I have to know more. This guy or girl is a great monster who I can totes see up there with the likes of the Birch, Looksie, and Soot. He or she deserves much more. I have nothing to add about the monster other than the demon is a cool Halloween-themed birch. Please, sir, I want some more.
Throw me a frickin' bone here.
I also like this episode more than Jack Attack, because we actually see a higher force at work guiding the pumpkins and getting its hands dirty, earning mad respect from me. Crypt TV has been hinting that there's some kind of divine pumpkin entity out there, causing jack-o'-lanterns to fight back against humanity's oppression, but they've never shined the spotlight fully on it. If Crypt TV wants to spawn the pumpkin monster into a full-on movie, well, there is enough interest from me to demand more of the plant beast. My only complaint with the Great Pumpkin is that it disappears once he or she curses the bully. Where the heck did the pumpkin creature go? Is it still out there revenging it up?
That's a good question! And the answer is...
The world may never know.
Preposterous!
Bottom line, this short film is good. Typical karma story, but one that has a mega creepy vagueness and stunning visual storytelling. Nothing mind-blowing, but it truly is a small, sweet, juicy treat that really screams Happy Halloween. So, I grant Crypt TV's spin on the Great Pumpkin Legend a gold skull. Sadly, not a perfect score, since I have seen far superior shorts from the Cryptverse. But this is a decent one that grows into something strong on its own. While the large age differences and lack of a more involved monster kind of take away from it, the film is shot flawlessly, is performed excellently, teaches a good lesson on karma, contains unnerving horror, and best of all, feels like a gripping Halloween present. The plot is simple enough to grasp, but this is a good case of how simple scales can still equal cool. I'd give it a watch just to get into the holiday spirit. While unlikely to win any horror contests, Jack-O-Lantern is simply a fun experience that will certainly carve a mark on your memory. Remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe, or just tune in for more videos posted here on Wolf Entertainment. I'm your plant-loving host, Catastrophe, and I want to remind you kids to never, ever smash another person's pumpkin, because then the pumpkins might want to smash you back. See you in Halloween.
Pumpkin segregation forever!